Hey guys, Spirit of the Law here. As Age of Empires players, we're pretty used to matching up units to try to counter each other and the basic cycles that can come out of this. There are lots of cycles like this, and they often become more complicated when you factor in the 50-ish land units in the game, and they start to get influenced by micro, and you have to think about cost effectiveness, and this is really why it's pointless to talk about a best unit most of the time. This is where a lot of the complexity of the game comes in, and also what makes it a lot of fun. Now this is all in contrast to the feudal water battles that happen in HD in Age of Conquerors, where there really is only one choice, the galley. That doesn't feel very Age of Empires-ish somehow, and just to briefly recap the last 16 years of online play, water battles have basically turned into who can execute their economy better and get out that one or two extra galleys first while the other player would run away until their fleet size could catch up. Granted, there are some more options in Castle Age, but even then you usually just saw big galley line battles, and demolition ships in particular never made an appearance. As I assume you know because you're watching this video, but maybe you don't, the new African Kingdom expansion added a precursor to the fireship and demolition ship in the Feudal Age that upgrade automatically when you research War Galley. So now there are three legitimate feudal warship lines, which creates a brand new triangle of counter units. This makes water battles now as much about correct matchups as early economy. Or does it? To what extent do these counters work, or is one type of ship still the strongest? In this video, I'm going to take a look at the three ships and try to empirically determine the degree to which they counter each other in Feudal Age, and maybe just throw some ideas out there for you to consider as we collectively start to figure out this new mechanic. Let's check it out. I'm going to start by going through the three ship types and a bit about them. We'll start with the galley. This is the classic ranged water unit. Now you're going to want to get fletching before you engage in any fights with them, so in Feudal Age you'll almost always see them with 6 range and the +1 attack, and that goes as an assumption for the entire video. They take 1 minute to create and there have been no changes to them in the expansion that I know of. They're quite good against fishing ships, doing 11 damage per attack, meaning they can sink a fishing ship in 16 seconds, or 6 can sink a fishing ship in 1 shot. Unless it's a Japanese fishing ship, of course, which take many more. They're also the only type of ship available that can actually be used to raid the shoreline, which you shouldn't underestimate. Galleys in our new triangle are of course countered by the fire galley. Fire galleys cost the same total number of resources, but you'll notice that the cost is shifted more toward gold. If we check out their stats, they look pretty weak statistically, but that can be quite misleading. They take 1 minute to create, which is the same as the galley, but they kill fishing ships in less than half the time of a galley, and they dominate the galley in similar size battles, taking 4 damage per shot and dealing out damage to the galleys at what appears to be 5 or 6 times that rate. Basically what's happening is it doesn't take most of the bonus damage versus ships that galleys normally dish out, and instead do their own bonus damage against ships, which is why they work so well despite terrible looking stats. The fireship in turn is countered by the Demolition Raft. Again, it has the same cost as the other ships if you add up all the resources, but the cost is shifted even further toward gold. These ones are a little different in that they take 45 seconds to create, which is faster than the other two ships, and they're a high damage single use area attack. One thing to know is their explosion doesn't hurt your own units, so you don't have to worry about them blowing each other up or any of your other ships. They're also the fastest of the ships, so you can't outrun them with any of the other types. Now while they don't take out fire galleys in one hit, the reason they could be considered a good counter to fire galleys is they're often able to damage 3 or 4 of them in a blast, making them potentially cost effective in the long run. So how are they against fishing ships? Well, they take them out in one hit, unless they're Japanese of course, but it's not a good idea to use them if you're just targeting one ship at a time. They cost quite a bit more than a fishing ship, so it's not a great exchange unless the fishing ships are all bunched up, in which case that can be pretty devastating. They do have some bonus damage against buildings as well, and they clearly do more than their 90 attack suggests, but that wouldn't be a sustainable way to take out docks. Also, big groups against each other isn't a great idea if you're the one with more of them, since they tend to cancel out and take a few extras with them. So what counters the Demo Raft? Well, to complete the triangle, it turns out to be galleys. galleys can destroy a demolition raft in 5 shots due to a combination of low pierce armor, low HP, and very little hidden defenses against ships. You can also spread the galleys out a bit, minimizing the blast damage. And let's be honest, demo rafts have some pretty dumb pathfinding on account of this being a 90s game. So it makes sense that galleys can usually take out quite a few of them in open water, while remember, fire ships were actively trying to engage the demo ships up close. Luckily, even a destroyed demo ship that doesn't hit its target still damages enemy units that are immediately around it. So now that we've been introduced to the options and we have a sense of what's supposed to happen, let's check out the matchups with a bit more rigor and under controlled conditions. All of these tests are going to be in a post-feudal tech level, so with fletching, and with 2 AIs against each other except where stated, so there won't be very effective micro, but at least it's the same for both sides. I'll use 8 ships for each side, since that's a normal fleet size during early encounters on the water. As another side note on an assumption here, I'm going to consider wood and gold to be of equal value in this situation, because we're assuming you're in Feudal Age with access to gold at its highest, and players rarely take advantage of either buying or selling wood at this point, purely for the purposes of being misvalued at the market, so I think they're about equal. The first matchup is the galley versus fire galley. This is a very easy matchup to test, since they have the same creation time and comparable cost. So it's realistic to think that 2 evenly matched players going for the water could produce roughly equal numbers if one was going blindly for galleys and the other one for fire galleys. The fire galleys typically lose 1 unit, but that's not a very sensitive measure and doesn't take into account how many are on partial health. Collectively, through 3 trials though, the fire galley still had an average of 81% of their combined health left over. When we take the unit costs into account, that means what I'm going to call their cost effectiveness ratio is 5.3, which is very good. That is not to say that one fire galley can take out 5 galleys, but that with equal number, the fire galleys seem very cost effective. Will that value change though if we introduce some micro? Well, fire galleys can't really use micro, since you'd normally just patrol them into the enemy or let them auto-attack, which will end up pretty similar to letting the AI do it. But if the galleys have some hit-and-run assistance, they do much better on a medium-sized lake, and the fire galleys are left with about 22% of their collective HP when I averaged it over a few times. On really open water, I can even win with the galleys. On that small lake, it moves the cost-effectiveness ratio I talked about down to 1.28 in favor of fire galleys from 5.3, and on the open water, the ratio was even 1.6 in favor of the galleys, meaning that the galleys were cost effective. It's a best case scenario of human against AI, but it again emphasizes for us the importance of focus firing and helping your units out. And the obvious conclusion is not to leave your galleys to look after themselves against fire ships. At the same time, you probably shouldn't take a fight with your fire ships against galleys if the other player is showing they're willing to hit and run your units across the map. The next matchup is the fire galley versus the demolition raft. Now this is a tougher matchup to balance, since the demolition ship is created 15 seconds faster, but I'm going to keep looking strictly at cost, which again, they have the same total cost of 120 resources. 8 on 8, we see the fire ships go down, but so do the demo ships. This happens with amazing regularity if the units are clumped together, but if the fire ships are separated, they can outlive the demo ships, meaning we could even think of the fire galley as a cost-effective exchange if you spread them out and you just let the demo rafts blow themselves up. I get the novelty of an area attack thing, but you have to be hitting 2 fire ships on average to make this work, and even if you're able to hit 3 or 4 at once, you don't end up with very many ships left in the end. Having the ships work with or without micro doesn't really make a difference either. It's a similar situation to the petards. The splash damage is just too small to guarantee multiple hits every time. I'm not saying the demo ship can't be useful against fire galleys, especially because you can build them a bit faster, but with equal resources, they're just not a cost-effective counter to fire galleys on their own, and pretty much equate to exchanging resources in the best case scenario. At the moment, this is creating a weak link in our triangle, which is starting to make the fire galleys look like an objectively best choice. Let's not jump to any conclusions quite yet though. If we stick with our 8 versus 8 with AIs, after 10 trials, the average actually works out to 0.99 cost effectiveness for the demolition raft. We'll finish off this part by looking at the demolition raft versus the galley. This is kind of a weird one as well. The demo ships do pretty well against the galleys, because the galleys tend to hold their tight formation. On several trials, it averages a 1.12 cost-effectiveness ratio in favor of the galleys. So in this situation, they tend to survive, but only with a few left over. Micro can affect the results of this one as well. If I take over the galleys, I can save 4 of them for a cost effectiveness ratio of 2. But if I micro the demo ships, I get a similar result to the AI of about an equal exchange. It looks like galleys are a reasonable counter to demolition rafts, which means it's going to be really hard to be cost effective with your demo ships if you're choosing it as your primary unit. They don't seem to be good against either of the other two types. Okay, so to put it all together, this is the triangle of cost effectiveness if we use 8 vs 8 with AIs. There's a pretty obvious imbalance here that the fire ship to galley counter is a very hard counter compared to the others, and the demo raft never really has a moment to shine. The galley isn't particularly great against it, so just using small numbers and AIs, we can't say there's a real rock-paper-scissors thing happening. Again, this is just having AIs pick their targets, and they're not very good at focus firing or doing hit and run with their galleys, so a high-skilled player against someone not paying attention could probably make any of these much more effective. Still, I was hoping for a little bit more obvious counter here between them. If I introduce my own admittedly unastounding micro and we look at the triangles again, we can see it really eliminates a lot of the imbalance. Basically meaning whatever unit you choose, it'll mostly come down to the player that has the better economy and therefore more ships, and that person's micro. Much like what the situation was before when we had only galleys. So when we put it all together, what's the takeaway? Well, I'll let you read into it how you like, but for me, it says the Fire Galley is probably the best default choice in the Feudal Age, given its effectiveness against fishing ships, galleys, and with equal exchange against demolition rafts. It's true that it can't raid the shore, but for water control, it seems to be the best choice, especially if you're unsure of what your opponent is going for. Even knowing your opponent might be going for fire ships should probably be enough to make you pause before making galleys as your default. You can't even feel safe going for the demo rafts as your default because they won't be strong against either of the other types, and it leaves you with nothing to take their fishing ships out with when you've taken out their navy. Basically, what seems to have started as 3 choices for the water in the Feudal Age has turned into 1. Just for fun and as a comparison, here are the values I found for the Pikeman, Knight, and Skirmisher triangle in the late Castle Age. The difference between this and the water balance is that there are many other units to choose from on land, or skirmishers probably wouldn't be chosen very often. And in practice, it's true, we only normally see them used as an anti-archer unit in the Castle Age. But before you go, I have one more idea. What about combinations of these units? Perhaps the combination becomes more than the sum of its parts. Well, using equal parts of all 3, that combination beats the galleys, loses to the fire galleys, and beats the demolition raft. That's exactly what we would expect if the Fire Galley is the most powerful unit of that group. If I control the assorted groups of ships, I can beat the Fire Galleys, but only because the AI is so exploitable. Basically what happens is the demolition rafts take out an equal value worth of fire ships, and then I get a fireship on fireship battle with my galleys in behind doing basically no damage, which under normal circumstances against a human player would mean my outnumbered fire galleys go down, quickly followed by my ineffective galleys. Against an AI, I can win because some units peace out, and I can also focus fire. It kind of looks like the fire galleys are going to be the new galleys, unless the demo ships get their blast radius expanded or something like that. So just to wrap up, I'm not saying never build anything but fire ships, and in fact, later in the game, you'll often want to go with galleons over fire ships because the range means you're going to have many ships firing at once, and it also gives you more coastal raiding potential. Though keep in mind that fast fire ships have essentially been given 3 extra armor in the expansions, so they're not as weak as they were before. In Feudal Age though, which I said at the beginning I was going to focus on specifically, the fireship appears to be the best choice as your first water unit, when your goal is destroying fishing ships and taking control of the water. So question for you, does that make the Byzantines the new Vikings? Well, their fire galleys are affected by the +20% fireship attack rate bonus, and maybe that's enough that the Byzantines will become a top tier water civilization, especially since the Vikings don't even get access to the fireship at all. Perhaps for the first time ever, the Vikings will become mortal on water. That's all for this one though. Thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you next time.